Good morning, children. Sidam. Today we are going to start with EVS 2. Chapter number 12, The Siege of Purandar and the Treaty with Mughal Emperor. This is part 2 and we are going to start this part with new words. So your first word is Howdha. H-O-U-D-A-H. Now Howdha means a seat on elephant's back. Misery, M-I-S-E-R-Y, misery, it means unhappiness. Shrewd, S-H-R-E-W-D, shrewd means intelligent, sharp-witted. Diplomat, D-I-P-L-O-M-A-T, diplomat means a person skilled in dealing with other people. Persuaded, P-E-R-S-U-A-D-E-D, persuaded, means to convince. Hones, now hones means a gold coin. Treaty, T-R-E-A-T-Y, now here treaty means agreement. Proved, P-R-O-V-E-D, proved means to demonstrate the truth. Treacherous, T-R-E-A-C-H-E-R-O-U-S. It means faithless, disloyal or betrayal. Now children, this is the content outline of this chapter. What we are going to learn today. Murar Baji's incomparable valor, Treaty of Purandar. Now Murar Baji's incomparable valor. Now we all know that the Mughal troops at last surrounded Murar Baji on all sides. Now because Murar Baji was entered with his soldiers in Dilir Khan's camp. When he was surrounded by the enemy, he was still not scared at all. Dilir Khan stopped the men. He said, wait. Hold back your swords. So the soldiers moved back a little. Then Dilir Khan addressed Murar Baji and said, until now, I have not seen a swordsman like you. You come over our side. I promise you complete safety. The emperor will make you a sardar and reward you with jagir. With a jagir. Now, Murar Baji was red with anger. He was red with anger. He was very angry. He said, we are loyal servants of Shivaji Maharaj. Who wants your jagir? Who wants your safety? I don't want anything, he said. And saying so, he continued fighting. So Dilir Khan started attacking him. He was seated on elephant's back. He released an arrow which pierced Murar Baji's neck. Sad to say, Murar Baji fell down to the ground. He died. But his men did not lose heart. They carried the dead body and took it back to the upper fort and said, what if Murar Baji is fallen? We too are brave like him. We will fight with courage. And saying so, they began to fight without losing their heart. When Shivaji heard this sad news about Murar Baji, he was greatly grieved and he did not want to lose his men at any cost who would die in this attempt. Now he knew that his soldiers were very brave and can stand against an army for at least a year or even more. But he did not want to do it. So now he wanted to put an end to all these wars. Treaty of Purandar. Now we know that Shivaji was sad on the death of his brave man Murar Baji. And so what did he do? He wanted to end all wars and fights. So he decided to sign a treaty with the Mughal emperor. So he went and met Jai Singh. Now who is Jai Singh? Mirza Rajai Jai Singh. Now this was a very sensible and statement like thing to do. Shivaji said to Jai Singh, Mirza Rajai, you are a Rajput. You can understand our suffering. The emperor's campaign have laid the country waste and people are in great misery. I have undertaken this task. Now, who was saying this? Yes, Shivaji was saying all this to Mirza Raje. Now, Shivaji said, I have taken this task of establishing Swaraj. So that people may be happy, may live a happy life. So you should join me in this task, and if you agree to lead us, myself and my mamlas will be your trusted followers. Jai Singh was a shrewd politician. Now he was a shrewd diplomat, sorry. Now he thought for a while and asked Shivaji to sign the treaty of peace. Now with the emperor. So now Shivaji also wanted peace, and so he decided to sign the treaty of peace with the Mughal emperor. Now, so according to the treaty, Shivaji had to give 23 forts and 4 lakh and a territory with a revenue of 4 lakh hones. Now, hones means gold coins. So, now this treaty was signed in 1665. After the treaty was signed, what happened? Yes, Mirza Raje Jai Singh suggested Shivaji that he should go to Agra and meet the emperor. Now, who was the emperor? Yes, Aurangzeb. Now, he also guaranteed his safe return. Shivaji knew it was not safe and the emperor could not be trusted. But he still decided to take the risk and face the situation. So, he informed Mirza Raje that he was willing to go to Agra to meet the emperor. Now, we will learn all this in detail, okay? Murar Baji's incomparable valor. Now, seeing Dilair Khan, Murar Baji asked his troops to attack his full force and himself advanced towards the Dilair Khan. Now, he was going towards Dilair Khan. Whoever tried to obstruct him was cut to pieces. So, Murar Baji was not leaving anybody. He was like cutting everyone and going ahead. The Mughal troops at last surrounded Murar Baji on all sides. Now, just Dilair Khan shouted, "Wait, hold back your swords." The Mughal troops waited and they moved back a little. Then Dilair Khan addressed Murar Baji, "Until now, I have not seen a swordsman like you. You come over our side, I promise you complete safety. The emperor will make you Sardar and reward you with a Jagir," he said to Murar Baji. Now, Murar Baji was very angry. His eyes were red with anger. Now, Murar Baji said in return to Dilair Khan that we are loyal servants of Shivaji Maharaj. Who wants to buy safety from you? Why should we come to your side? And who wants your emperor's Jagir? Now, then he moved forward in the direction and of Dilair Khan and started attacking once again. He started fighting again with the soldiers. So, Dilair Khan who was seated in the howdah, means on the elephant's back, he released an arrow which pierced Murar Baji's neck. Murar Baji fell to the ground. Now, his followers lifted his dead body. The soldiers lifted his dead body and took it back to the upper fort. Now they also said that what if one Murar Baji is fallen? We too are brave like him. Even we can fight. We will fight with courage. Now saying so, they begin to fight again without losing their heart. Now Shivaji heard this sad news he was deeply grieved. And he knew that he could not hold each one of his forts against the Mughal army for at least now. But still he can hold at least 1 year. But why to lose our gem? Why to lose precious men like Murar Baji? But he was unwilling to do so at any cost to lose them. So because they were dying in all this fight and all. So, he was not willing to go for a war. Treaty of Purandar. Now, what could be done? he was not strong enough to fight the powerful Mughals. Now Shivaji was not very powerful, he was not having a big army to fight with Mughal Emperor. So all his political skill was also of no avail. Now there was only one thing that he could do. So he decided a temporary withdrawal from the fight. So he would enter into a treaty with the Mughal Emperor. Now treaty means agreement that yes, we will not fight for so and so years. Okay, so now we are friends. So that is an agreement. So he went to Jai Singh, Mirza Rache Jai Singh. He went and went to meet Mirza Rache Jai Singh. Now this was a very sensible statement like thing to do. He said to Mirza Rache Jai Singh that Mirza Rache, you are a Rajput. Now you can understand our suffering. The emperor's campaign have laid the country waste and people are in great misery. I have undertaken this task of establishing Swaraj so that people may be happy over there. So you should join me in this campaign if you agree to lead us. Myself and my mawlas will be your trusted followers. Now Jai Singh was a shrewd diplomat. Now he persuaded Shivaji to sign a treaty of peace with the emperor. Now who was the emperor? Yes, Aurangzeb. Now Shivaji signed the treaty, and according to its all the terms of the treaty, he gave 23 forts, a territory with a revenue of 4 lakh horns, means gold coins. You can see image in front of you. 23 forts, 4 lakh, a territory with a revenue of 4 lakh horns were to be handed over to the emperor. Now the Treaty of Purandar was signed in 1665. After the treaty was signed, Jai Singh suggested to Shivaji that he should go to Agra and see the emperor. He should go to Agra and meet the emperor. So he also guaranteed Shivaji's safe return. Now Shivaji thought over his suggestion that because he knew that the emperor could not be trusted. Now he had proved treacherous to his own brothers. He has given risk to his own brothers, the Mughal Emperor. But in the end, Shivaji decided to take the risk and face the situation as cautiously as he could. He informed Jai Singh that he was willing to go to Agra to meet the Emperor. Now children, we will start with our assessment. Fill in the blanks by choosing the correct option. Dash was seated in the howdah on the elephant's back. Murar Baji, Dilir Khan, Fazal Khan. And the correct answer is Dilir Khan. Dilir Khan released an arrow which pierced Dash's neck. Baji Prabhu's, Siddhi Johar's, Murar Baji's. Yes, and the correct answer is Murar Baji's. Third one, Dash decided temporary withdrawal from the fight. Shahaji, Shivaji, Baji Prabhu. Yes, and the correct answer is Shivaji decided temporary withdrawal from the fight. Mirza Rache persuaded Shivaji to sign a treaty of Dash with the emperor. Friendship, war, peace. Yes, and the correct answer is peace. Who said to whom? Who wants your emperor's jagir? Murar Baji said to Dilir Khan, or Dilir Khan said to Murar Baji? The correct answer is Dilir Khan. If you agree to lead us, myself and my mawlas will be your trusted followers. Mirza Rache said to Shivaji, or Shivaji said to Mirza Rache? And the correct answer is Shivaji said to Mirza Rache. Name the following. Who laid siege to Purandar? Diler Khan or Murar Baji? The correct answer is Diler Khan. Who was a shrewd diplomat? Baji Prabhu, Mirza Rajay Jai Singh. The correct answer is Mirza Rajay Jai Singh. Who carried out his daring deed on Surat? Shahaji Raje or Shivaji Maharaj? Shivaji Maharaj. Who defended Purandar? Who defended Purandar? Murar Baji or Mirza Raje? Correct answer, Murar Baji. Thank you.